One championship is starting a revolution in submission grappling.
Ooh, sorry, ladies and gentlemen, that looks very painful.
One championship just did more for grappling than perhaps anything has ever been done for grappling in history. The opportunity and the exposure that Chachere is giving to pure grappling. Not to mention, I love the rules.
Unlike traditional grappling tournaments, One's unique rule set values offense and aggression above all else.
The only way to win the match is if you have the most submission catches.
Next!
With legit finishes. You cannot stall. You'll instantly be penalized, so you have to be finishing the match. So you just see two people constantly throwing submissions at each other and trying to finish the match.
I love to see grappling in a cage at mixed martial arts events. You see the same takedowns, the same work on the cage, the ground grappling, the submissions that they're familiar with from MMA in an almost more pure form, where you get to see the grappling without the interruption of strikes.
That means no stop. That means a pure action. One championship is changing the game for real. Whole new era of grappling inside the One Championship circle.
One is doing such amazing job, showcase like the grappling side to all the fans so they can kind of start understanding more the grappling aspect of martial arts.
One Championship is really changing what it is they bring us. This has really never been done before, not to this extent.
The future is now.
One Fight Night 10 on Prime Video May 5th is gonna feature two amazing submission grappling matches that you do not wanna miss. Reinier the Ritter versus Tye Ruotolo. I think we're gonna see a clash of styles, but not as much as people think. There will be a size discrepancy. RDR will be significantly bigger than Tye. However, Tye is a big kid naturally. He's tall, he's not small. On top of that, Tye trains with some of the strongest athletes in the world. I do not believe RDR's size will be that big of a problem for Tye. RDR's key to victory is to slow Tye down, try to get on top, keep him against the cage, try to grind him through. He's not gonna allow Tye to move his arms. He's gonna be smashed up against the cage, and that's a place where RDR has more experience. It's really hard to break an MMA guy in 10 minutes. However, I think what we see with Tye is someone who is purely focused on submission grappling that is the absolute best in the world. He could hit a submission from anywhere. Tye's key to victory, keeping the fight in the middle of the cage, not getting pushed up against the cage. He will make it a legit submission grappling match, and I believe it will not be very hard for Tye to find victory if he's able to do that. Tye will go down as one of the best to ever do it in history.
This man is one of the most exciting grapplers on the planet.
That is a grappling match I would love to see.
Probably the person who just won no gi world, his name's Osamah. That would be an awesome match in May in Colorado.
Mikey Musumeci versus Osamah Almarwai for the one flyweight submission grappling world title. It's going to be very, very exciting. Mikey is one of the all-time winningest competitors ever. He has a style that just constantly looks for the finish. Mikey has already proved himself to win in this rule set. Osamah is a no-gi world champion and no-gi Pan-American champion in the black belt divisions. He is ranked number one in the world for IBJJF. That being said, Mikey goes for the finish. He's beaten the absolute legends of the game. Osamah can stop Mikey. He has to take away Mikey's movement and take away Mikey's ability to roll. If you have him up against a cage, he cannot find the back and he's gonna be very limited into what he's doing. If Mikey can just stay off the cage and work his magic, I believe we will see magic happen. Mikey likes to hit submissions from everywhere. He is something special.
One of the greatest grapplers we've ever seen.
One Fight Night 10, you will witness two of the most exciting submission grappling matches. All competitors are very explosive, very submission orientated. They look for the finish 100% of the time, and they all want to win.